Two-factor authentication. Accessing eRA modules via login.gov. eRA is moving to two-factor authentication using login.gov, meaning access to eRA systems will require something you know, a password, and something you have, a phone or other device. This new login method will become standard for users of eRA Commons, Commons Mobile, IAR, and Assist. In this video tutorial, we will demonstrate how to create a login.gov account, associate it to your existing eRA Commons account, and log in to an eRA module using the new login.gov account. We will use eRA Commons as an example. Note: these steps are assuming you do not already have a login.gov account. We will look at the scenario of what to do if you already have a login.gov account in a moment. Set up your login.gov account. First, navigate to the eRA Commons homepage. Before you begin the process of setting up your login.gov account, it is important to be sure your eRA Commons password is current and valid. If you have forgotten your password, or it has expired, you can use the Forgot Password, Unlock Account link on the eRA Commons login page to reset your password, or contact your eRA signing official for assistance with resetting your password. To start the process of creating your login.gov account, along the left side of the page, near the top, find the Login with login.gov portion of the page, and click on the login.gov logo. You'll be presented with a confirmation and instructional dialog box. Read the information and click Continue to proceed. This will redirect you to the login.gov sign-in page. Here you will find a link to create an account. Clicking the link will bring you to the Create Your Account screen. First, enter your email address. This address will be the primary email address used for your new login.gov account. Next, select your email language preference. You can choose from English, Spanish, or French. Before the Submit button is enabled, you will need to check the box to accept the login.gov rules of use. When done, click the Submit button to initiate the next action. An email from login.gov will be sent to that address, and within the message will be a button to confirm the email address. Click the button to proceed. Next, you will be asked to create a strong password. As you type in the characters of your password, login.gov will measure the strength of the password. Click Continue when you are done. The next step is to set up your authentication method. You have 5 options. 1. The use of a security key. 2. If you are a government employee, you can use your personal identity verification card or PIV card. 3. An authentication application, such as Duo, Google Authenticator, or Authy. 4. A phone, either cellular or landline, but not web-based voice over IP phones. Or 5. Backup codes, which is the least secure option, and are intended as a fallback option if other verification methods are not available. For this demonstration, we will use the phone option. After selecting the authentication method, click Continue. You will enter your phone number, and then select how to receive your code. Remember, if you are using a landline that does not support text messages, select the phone call option. Click Send Code when done. Next, you will enter the security code you received, clicking the Submit button when done. If login.gov successfully verifies the code, you will see a confirmation screen that you are signing in for the first time. Click Agree and Continue to go to the next step. Associate login.gov with eRA Commons. Clicking Continue will bring you back to the eRA Commons system. Since this is your first time coming to the eRA system with a login.gov account, your login.gov account will not be associated with your existing eRA Commons user account. In order to create that association, you will need to enter your eRA Commons credentials, your user ID and password. After entering your credentials, click Continue. This will create the link between your login.gov account and your eRA Commons account. This is a one-time setup process and will not need to be done again, unless you decide to use a different login.gov account. From this point forward, you will use the login.gov option on the eRA Commons homepage to access eRA Commons. Authenticate with your login.gov credentials and the additional authentication method you set up with your login.gov account. If you do not want to enter a code every time, click the box that states, "Remember this browser." If you use the same browser and computer to log into eRA Commons, login.gov will remember these settings and not require you to enter the two-factor authentication source each time you want to log in, and you will go directly to eRA Commons. Remember, to access eRA Commons, you will go to the eRA Commons login page and select the login.gov option. Do not go directly to login.gov and attempt to log in there. That will get you to your account settings page. This is helpful if you wish to change your login.gov password or add additional authentication methods. A second authentication option can be used if your first or primary authentication method is not available. For example, if you don't have your cell phone with you to receive the authentication code text message, you can select a different authentication method. What to do if you already have a login.gov account? If you have an existing login.gov account, you will simply go to the eRA Commons login page, select the login.gov option, and associate your login.gov account to your eRA Commons account, as already demonstrated. There are a variety of resources available to you should you need help with creating your login.gov account and associating it with your eRA Commons account. If you are still having issues with login.gov, to authenticate to eRA Commons, visit the login.gov contact page. For issues related to your eRA account or to associating your login.gov account with your eRA account, contact the eRA service desk. This concludes this tutorial on demonstrating how to create a login.gov account, associate it to your existing eRA Commons account, and log in to an eRA module using the login.gov option. Thank you for watching.